Neve had ridden out of Lyria in early spring, her retinue modest, as none larger was needed for the brief summit of sovereigns. She returned now to her capital, at the head of an army that dragged behind it bandits and Nilfgaardian prisoners in chains. The whole city came out to greet her. Its traders, craftsfolk, priests. Also, her eldest son and heir, Prince Willem. A boy who, it seemed, might never be prepared to rule. Neve and Willem rode side by side past the cheering throngs, their faces frozen in regal smiles. It was not until they reached the castle stables that they found a corner in which to speak freely, candidly.
Welcome home, Mother. Content I am to see you, to be sure.
And I'm happy to see you. Though I dare say I'd have been much happier to witness you leading an army towards Dravograd. Willem, I trusted you. Left the realm in your care.
Indeed. And I, in turn, did my utmost to choose the best course for...
Willem, don't be so damned courtly. There's no one else here. My son. Nilfgaard has invaded our home. We're at war. When rulers don't strive and don't choose, when rulers grab their swords and shields and ride out to defend their subjects.
You didn't let me finish.
All right. Say what you wanted to, please.
I feared I'd be hasty, Mother, and I didn't want to be. When we got word of the invasion, the lords convened at the castle. They demanded I hear them out. They wanted to give me counsel. If I'd rushed into the field to confront the foe, I'd have been half blind to the situation, not known all the options I had at my disposal.
A ruler never knows all the options, yet he must decide and act nonetheless. I need to prepare. I'll see you at the Council of Peers.
And indeed she did, when the peers convened in the throne room. Surrounded by animal hides and Zerikanian tapestries, the Lord stood in tense silence, awaiting the Queen. When her figure filled the doorway, they fawningly prostrated themselves.
We've myriad matters to resolve, so I trust you're well rested. Whatever the case, I've no doubt we shall meet the Dawn afore we're done. Firstly, we must ask assistance. Pen a letter to King Demavend. Scribe, take this down. Dear... what? Uncle? Cousin? Blast. Again. I, Meave, by the God's grace, sovereign of Rivia and...
Your grace? Mother, the peers and I, we've come to propose another solution.
Yes, out with it.
We wish to acknowledge Nilfgaard's authority. Pledge fealty to the Emperor.
I beg your pardon.
The black-clad hordes outnumber our forces manyfold, and they're far better equipped. We stand not the slightest chance against them in open...
You will not lecture me about Nilfgaard's army, my son. All you know of them you garnered from coloured renderings, whereas I faced them at Dravograd. I faced them and crushed them.
But your grace, the losses... For this fleeting victory in which you delight, how many of your subjects had to perish? Bend a knee afore the Emperor, and you shall spare thousands.
Nay, never! Understood, Caldwell, not ever!
I'd hoped to persuade you, but it seems I've failed. Nonetheless, the die's been cast. We've signed the accord with Nilfgaard. Our noble lord, stand with me.
The blood left Meave's face. She had realized her son, who had ever professed to detest politics and shirked his duties as crown prince, had just stabbed her in the back, as had her entire court.
What is this? Treason to my eyes! The gallows is what awaits you!
Willem rules Lyria now. And should you not acquiesce and approve the accord, I fear only you, m'lady, shall have the pleasure to meet the hangman.
Don't get ahead of yourself, Caldwell. My mother will not be harmed. Not one hair on her head. Understood? Confine the Queen to the tower.
You err deeply, my son.
The Queen was confined to a cell. Gilded armor she had traded for a simple robe. A courtly retinue for a swarm of rats. She was the very picture of misery. At the window of her cell, gripping the bars, Meave stood powerless, her anger so great she wept and wailed. Her Lyria was free no more.
Have I come at a bad time?
Demons take you, Caldwell. You've long been at this scheme, haven't you? You left the strays of Sparla to roam the realm, to forage, so that I would have to look to them. And thus gained your cohorts the time they needed to complete Lyria's sail to Nilfgaard.
You've seen through it all, that's clear. After the fact, of course, but still.
Willem, you turned him. How?
The boy's not fit to wear the crown. Hasn't sufficient wit nor valor. I know this. You know this. Just, he knows it not. Willem fancied himself a statesman, which terribly to prove he was one. I made it possible. I've been amply rewarded, I have. Palatine since just yesterday, in fact.
You'll have neither my blessing nor congratulations. Sorry to disappoint you.
I seek neither. I've come for another reason. To bid you adieu. Willem does not seek your death. Does not even fathom it, as you well know. Moreover, his resolve will wilt in time, and he'll wish to free you. So, come the morn, when the young king rides out to pledge fealty afore General Epdahi, you shall use your bed linens to hang yourself.
I see. You wish to see me bow before you, lie prostrate, beg you for mercy, plough yourself with a pike, Caldwell. And you needn't send your thugs. I'll not falter nor hesitate. I'll take my own life.
Adieu, Your Grace. And use your last evening wisely.
Meave felt a rush of despair, yet bit her lip to mute any weeping. No, she would not give Caldwell the satisfaction. Morning arrived with the sound of footsteps in the corridor. Meave rose from her cot and stood in the center of her cell. She was prepared for anything. Well, nearly anything.
The Duke of Dogs?
Titles seem senseless under the circumstances, don't you think? Let's forgo them. I'm Gascon.
Has Caldwell sent you? To kill me?
No and a no. Actually, you're free. How shall I put this? That cad, Count Caldwell, used yours truly and the strays as bait in a scheme aimed at kicking your shapely backside off your throne. Now, I'm hardly vindictive. First to forgive, in fact. Take your threat to send me to the gallows. Forgotten already. Yet being played for a fool, I cannot abide. So when the strays freed me, I knew what I'd do to spite the count afore I disappeared. I'd free you. That's to say, on one condition. You've got to request it of me, m'lady. Courteously.
For my realm I will do this, and much, much more. Even bow afore a brigand. Thus I beg you, Gascon, Duke of Dogs, grant me my freedom.
Ha! Incredible! I've lived to see someone grovel with dignity. A true ruler you've got to be. You are free.
I'm grateful. Now please let me pass. I must get to the city jail at once.
Would you look at this woman? Free her from one prison, she flies off to the next.
They hold Reynard there. And if I've any ally left, anyone who's not betrayed me, it's him. I must get him out.
Hold, m'lady. Unarmed, alone.
Have I any other option?
In a sense. See, they locked a few strays in the city pits, too. Got a common cause, I'd say. Care to join forces?
The Queen took Gascon up on his offer. Then she, Gascon, and the strays snuck through the city to its dungeon. Reynard had not wavered for a moment in his devotion to the Queen. Never the Slouch, he had also not lost any time.
I've inquired among the other arrested soldiers. Many are prepared to fight, even die at your side, Your Grace.
Seems they may yet get their chance. But now we must flee. All of us.
Yet in leaving the jail, the company ran into trouble. When Caldwell's cutthroats had failed to find Meave in her cell waiting for her secret execution, they had informed the Count. He, in turn, dispatched patrols into the streets. The Queen and her cohorts ran into one such unit.
Blast! We shan't outrun them. To arms! Gascon? Bloody hell, where'd he get to?
Your Grace, we must make haste. Caldwell's roused the whole city by now.
This harvest, we'll be reaping black clad heads.
Sod it. Sod it all.
Willing and how, but these damn boots are killing me.
Don't like this.
There's a time to reap, a time to sow.
Didn't think I'd leave you just like that, did you?
Honestly, I did.
We'll catch them all!
Army's a waste of time for one like me.
Your Grace, what guarantee do we have that they won't stab us in the back?
I smell a leak.
As you wish, m'lady.
Sod it. Sod it all.
You mad? Don't shake that!
Left, right, left, right.
favourite cut of lamb? The shank.
Again and again and again.
Lyria!
Ever have a storm knock out one of your teeth?
I thank you, Gascon. You and your men. For your aid.
Tis now, my lady. Strays never say no to a proper brawl.
No brawl this was. Sun rising against Mother. Lyrian striking at Lyrian. I fear a blood war's begun.
Come now. Seems to me the war's ended. Your realm's lost to Nilfgaard. You've no army to speak of.
Then I shall assemble a new one. And with it have Caldwell hanged. And drive Nilfgaard back across the Yruga.
You're mad. How will you find the men? Riding from hamlet to hamlet, speaking from atop a crate?
No. I shall find them in Edirn. I've a favour to call in with King Demavend, and I'll sway volunteers to my cause on the way.
Well, you've your first willing warriors already.
How so?
We've nothing left in Lyria. Our hideouts are compromised, Caldwell's sure to set a price on our heads, and Nilfgaardians roam the land in numbers.
Besides, I'll be right tickled to see proud Queen Meave fighting elbow to elbow with a bandit she'd wish to hang just a half day afore.
Well, it is said my foe's foe is my friend, and I'd be a fool to turn down assistance now, no matter who offers. So be it.
Very high-minded of you, m'lady. So, shall we shake on't? Nay? Well then, the high road beckons. Though first we must escape the city with our lives. Follow me.
Lyria was hers no more. Meave now had to flee her capital and realm as quickly as she could. Wont to travel the city streets in a gilded carriage, the Queen now saw them from a slightly different vantage point.
Ugh. Is this the only way? Are you quite certain? The Queen
is a common fugitive now, so she'd do better to pinch her nose and whinge not at all.
At long last, Meave reached the gate. Yet this she found shut tight, locked and guarded.
Gods be damned!
Easy, Your Grace. Nothing we can't solve with a quiver full of quarrels.
Those are our men.
They were, Reynard, were.
Gascon's raiders were poised to loose their bolts, but were thwarted when the Queen stepped out in front of them.
What's she?
Your Majesty, I've orders to arrest Your Grace.
Place me in irons, then.
Please understand, I haven't a choice.
Fear not. You'll be rewarded by Caldwell in Nilfgaardian florins.
The captain's head dropped. His cheeks burned crimson.
Go, Your Grace. Flee now, but only to return.
Remember this, Gascon. I'm no fugitive. I'm a queen robbed of her rightful crown. And though I may need to venture to the world's end before I return, I shall have it back.
Having fled Lyria, Queen Meave ventured into Edirne, her old friend Reynard and new ally Gascon at her side. The war had bitten into this land too. Still, Meave hoped to sway King Demoven to her cause, and with his aid, to oust the traitors, retake her throne, and drive the Nilfgaardian invader from her realm. Yet to start, she was forced to fight, Scoia'tael no less. Emerging from a wood, Meave's retinue encountered a unit of elven rebels just moments from hanging a handful of prisoners. Among the latter, the queen spotted a woman, a proud warrior with a striking, thick black braid.
The lass I believe I know.
Well, unless we rush to her rescue, it'll soon be you knew her.
Well said. Lyrians, attack!
One thinking.
She can't breathe, Your Grace. We must rush to her aid. This could hurt.
Thing about slings, they hide well.
Dol! Blathana!
Free the warrior!
Get our asses moving.
None shall tread on us!
The elves! Scatter them! They block our path!
We will.
will see who is weak.
Prepare to fight, if you've any honor.
If anyone asks, you've not seen me.
You must sweat like a swine in that jacket.
Ever have a storm knock out one of your teeth?
Too late. Hang the butcher! Villoa!
Can't breathe, Your Grace. We must rush to our aid. Ever have a storm knock out one of your teeth?
Kayam!
Free the warrior!
Her Majesty knows what she's doing.
Now we will see who is weak!
The elves! Scatter them! They block our path!
Tell me you jest.
Bring the butcher! Villoa!
Nay. Dwan Vekin.
I can't breathe, Your Grace. We must rush to her aid.
Prepare to fight, if you've any honor.
Coin never stinks, no matter how rank the pouch. Kayam!
Free the warrior!
We got a job to do.
I shall not fail!
The elves! Scatter them! They block our...
Tell me you jest.
Wait, you're serious?
Too late.
Hang the butcher, Villoa.
Edoran!
She can't breathe, Your Grace. We must rush to her aid.
Coin never stinks, no matter how rank the pouch.
Nay, Dwan Vekinest.
Watch your heads!
Kayadmil and Shay.
Free the warrior!
Ever have a storm knock out one of your teeth?
None shall tread on us!
The elves! Scatter them! They block our path!
You must sweat like a swine in that jacket.
We're too late.
Villoa!
Edoran!
She can't breathe, Your Grace. We must rush to her aid.
Catch!
Dwan Vekamest.
The chase is on!
Cadmel and ship.
Free the warrior!
Bigger they are, easier they are to tap.
Now we will see who is weak.
The elves! Scatter them! They block our path!
I shall not fail!
I smell a leak.
What do you want of me?
Thing about slings, they hide well.
Squiretel warriors shot the queen with their speed, their cunning, and their cruelty. Yet in the end, the Lyrians prevailed. When the last elf hit the ground, the queen had her men untie those they'd sought to hang.
1,000 thanks, your grace. There are many tales of your valor. Pleased to see there weren't just flattery and propaganda. I'm
Black Rayla. Haga, we saw you there. You command King Demoven's special forces.
That's right. Though not many remain to command.
So I see. How did it come to this?
My liege sent me to wipe out a Scoia'tael band, led by a rat called Eldaine. Followed the vermin's tracks for several days, straight into his trap, turned out.
Hunting elves in the woods. Truly inspired, I must say.
Had no choice. Doing nothing would have brought a surer, swifter doom. The Black Clad have invaded Edirne, thanks to elven aid. They snap our supply lines, lurk like dogs, prey on vulnerable units and scouts.
You mean to say Nilfgaard's broken your defences?
Aye. Though their march will soon halt, believe me. To advance, they'll have to take Rosberg, a stronghold that's yet to fall once. They'll break against its walls like waves upon the rocks.
While Edirne stands, the North is not yet lost.
I'll convey your Grace's words to the King at the first occasion.
I'd rather hope to convey them myself. I have come to Edirne seeking aid. I wish to ask Demoven for support.
The King is in Rosberg, overseeing siege preparations. I'm heading that way too to report on our skirmish with the Scoia'tael.
I might serve as your guide. These lands I know better than any.
Excellent. Guide on. Gods. The entire country up in flames.
Eptahi warned punishment awaited Edirne, that he would show the land no mercy.
What in God's names did you do to him, Rayla?
Nilfgaard offered us an alliance against the rest of the north, but Demoven declined in his clipped soldier's speech. They say Eptahi flew into a rage and swore he'd reduce Edirne to rubble.
Thank you.
How fare you, Rayla? The quartermaster, did he assign you a tent?
He tried.
Oh, and?
I refused it. Best to sleep beneath the stars. Little chance of a foe catching you off guard.
Rain accepted, perhaps.
I'm not made of sugar, ma'am. I'm not going to melt.
One sees very few women in the ranks, let alone in the special forces. How did you come to join?
On merit. Proved I'd be of use.
Yes, well, naturally. But how exactly?
I was 15 when I went to enlist. But the sergeant in charge of signing folk up told me to scurry on home. So I proposed a wager. Arm wrestling. If I won, he'd let me join. If I lost, I'd pay him 100 crowns.
And that kind of coin? You had it?
No. So I had to win. As we sat down at the table, across from each other, he laughed and rolled up his sleeve. When it was over, all around us were laughing at him. Then I just followed orders. Did so well enough to draw the king's attention.
I must go. We'll speak later. So, Gascon, the soldier's life, does it suit you?
About the same as the bandit's life did.
I beg your pardon?
The tents are cold, the food's shite. On the plus side, plenty to drink, most days. A skirmish here, a scuffle there, Nilfgaardians one day, elves the next, and whoever we rout, we rob of what they've got.
Requisition, you mean? Fully in accordance with the laws of war.
Oh, please. Save your excuses for your father confessor.
The Duke of Dogs. Whence the name?
Not certain I should tell you. It's a personal story, somewhat.
I insist.
So, thing is, I'm a werewolf of sorts.
Did I hear werewolf?
Of sorts. You see, when the full moon glows in the night sky, I transform into a creature that's half man, half Dachshund. And then all the other hounds of the night hearken to my command. Howl!
Oh, forget I asked.
With pleasure.
I can't stop wondering. How did your strays break into the tower in Lyria?
They exploited its chief weakness.
What weakness is that? I oversaw its construction myself. Walls 5 feet thick, bars and grates of the sturdiest iron.
All tremendous, I'm sure. But how much do you pay the guards?
What? I don't know. The garrison's commander is in charge of that.
Let me tell you then. Not much, Meave. Not much at all. From atop a throne, it's hard to spot the little things. Example, a guard hard up for coin, or one with ambitions. But seeing that's second nature to even the most ordinary bandit. Take any castle door. To open it, to open all, one needs but a pouch of gold.
It's time I attended to other matters. Farewell.
Your Grace, how fortunate you're here. Behold what wickedness is afoot.
I'm trying to behold Sir Ake, yet I cannot be sure what.
Reynard and Gascon, my lady. Caught in the act of playing face cards.
Oh, that. Indeed they are. Good.
Good? Games of chance, good. Why, they are evil's very claws. Corrupting, tearing at the soul, seeping venom into the heart.
I wouldn't worry about Reynard's heart, Sir Ake. As for Gascon's, too late already, I fear. Besides, they're getting along, that's what matters. If cards do the trick, so be it. Does the good book contain an answer to every question?
Each and every query, without exception.
What does it prescribe a mother betrayed by her son? Tender forgiveness or unflinching firmness?
A moment while I ponder. There's a verse in chapter 2. A child who doth with waywardness defy his mother and father deserveth discipline most severe. Strike him thus heartily, unless thine heart stilleth thy hand.
But one could interpret that any way one wishes.
To thine own self be judge and ruler, spoke the prophet Lebioda. For thou alone shalt answer for thine deeds before thee.
There's a certain wisdom to those words.
Yes, Your Majesty. One need but gaze deeply into the verses and oneself.
Farewell, Ake.
Yes, Your Grace?
How has it come to this? I, Queen Meave of Lyria and Rivia, must prowl about the underbrush like a common bandit. And you, General Rayna Dodo, once proud commander of four elite regiments of footmen, now lead a gang of deserters, bandits, and scythe-wielding peasants.
I do so proudly, Your Grace.
You must be joking, Reynard.
Your Majesty, under your husband I served 10 years, under you another 8. And never in that time did I fight for a more worthy cause. We seek not to grab land or stifle a peasant revolt. We fight for all the North, for our freedom, that of others, and you alone didn't give up. Didn't even consider bending the knee before Nilfgaard.
Yes, all true. Yet look where it's brought me.
Your struggle has but begun, Your Grace, and I will do all in my power to see you triumph in the end.
I cannot forgive myself one thing, that I failed to see through Caldwell's schemes. He must have plotted treason for months, years even, yet I suspected nothing.
Don't be too hard on yourself, Your Grace.
Easily said. Oh, if I'd only realized it in time.
Nilfgaard would have found a different traitor, or sent an assassin north. It was unavoidable what happened. The Black Clads would have attacked in any case, and we'd have stood no chance to defeat the foe in open battle, repel him, drive him out.
So, had you been there when the peers assembled, you also would have voted to bend the knee?
No. My honor would never have allowed it. I'd have thrown myself into the fire, and probably died a fool for it. As matters stand, I still have a chance to thwart the invader, his intentions. It seems, in a twisted turn of fate, I should be grateful to Caldwell.
It's time I attended to other matters.